Let's go.
This used to be a trade route for merchants crossing the scars. Till the Republic laid a new road wide enough to let wagons pass, and all official traffic moved there.
Leaving this one for those living outside the law.
Indeed. I doubt we'll be the only outlaws on the trail today.
Lucky to make it out alive.
Really? It's as bad as that?
Oh, aye. There's trouble up ahead. And too much of it for us to handle.
I take it there's danger on the road.
Oh, what about this fearsome-looking fellow? You think he'd be equal to the task?
Well, no doubt. Assuming he's willing to hear us out. Well met, friend. My brother and I have been tasked with finding a merchant's missing cart. You seen it by any chance?
How does a merchant misplace his cart?
Oh, the man's a coward. When he thought goblins might come a-snarling, he ran, leaving his livelihood abandoned in the pass.
He sent the two of us to fetch it, but it's gone. Now, I'm not much of a thinker, but I know the work of thieves when I see it.
My brother's right on all accounts. And by my estimation, the bastards are lying in wait just down the road.
We may have seen our share of action, true, but we've not got the skill in arms to boldly brave an ambush.
You, however, have the look of a man who needn't fear a band of backwater ruffians. What do you say? Will you help us out? Chances are they'll come for you either way. But if you promise to lend us a hand, at least you'll pocket a reward for your troubles.
Well, if I'm going to have to deal with them anyway.
You've clearly got a fine head on those broad shoulders.
We're lucky you came along. Now, hoping to make a heavy purse in Boklad, our merchant friend loaded his cart with as much as it would carry. Reckon he won't be forking over the rest of our fee if we don't find those goods. So, while you're seeing to those bandits, you keep your eyes open.
All right. Just don't expect me to drag the cart out of there myself.
You can leave the cart to us. You just put an end to those bandits and point us in the right direction. You do that, we'll take care of the rest.
You'll be doing Boklad a favor if you can clear out that pass. Why, I dare say they'll give you a hero's welcome.
I'm not sure I trust those two, but if there are bandits lying in wait, I should probably take care of them.
Look lively, you lot!
Well, we've got guests!
These must be our bandits.
Ah! to me, boy. Help me, boy.
Them dealt with. Now, where's that cart? Getting all of this out of here will be a nightmare.
Seems we found ourselves the right man for the job, wouldn't you say?
Found the cart and didn't leave a single bastard breathing. Our merchant friend will be delighted.
And how exactly will he be getting his goods out of here?
You leave that to us. After all, it'd be wrong to make such a fine warrior haul cabbages to market.
You've done your part. And that's all you need to worry about. Here. It's been a pleasure. Now piss off.
There's no need to be so rude, brother. What if we want his help again next time?
People take notice of wealthy men. Shouldn't be too hard to track down Karen's collector.
My carpets have pride of place in... Saint Drake's fang is gone. The whole mother.
Back again, are you? Any more trouble and you'll be barred for life. However deep.
Yeah.
You don't know for sure. Listen, it could have just been a tremor.
I've got this.
Welcome. If you're hoping for a bed, I'm afraid you'll have to look elsewhere. One of our wealthy patrons has purchased the use of every room, hoping to keep out the riffraff, as he puts it.
My reputation will be ruined! Ruined!
Calm yourself, Lord Ignac, I beg of you, before you do yourself a mischief.
Pardon the intrusion, but...
Out! Get out! I paid for these rooms so I wouldn't be disturbed. Leave me be!
Please, allow me to apologize. His lordship is going through a difficult time, and he's never been fond of guests arriving unannounced.
Radim! Get rid of the filthy oaf this instant!
Very good, Lord Ignac. Would you mind stepping outside for a moment?
I'm sorry if I've caused you any trouble.
That? Oh, no, no. That's just how his lordship is. Though the morning's events have left him somewhat fractious. He's been dispossessed of his luggage, you see. The thieves also made away with a considerable amount of coin. Coin the innkeeper will soon be keen to collect.
I don't suppose a certain blade was among the stolen items. A single-edged sword. It was purchased from a merchant friend of mine.
Ah, you know Lady Curran? Yes, I'm afraid it was.
Then I'll retrieve Lord Ignac's luggage. But I have one condition.
You have but to state it. You are welcome to anything that is within my power to grant.
I want an audience with Lord Ignac. A few minutes should be enough. Then I'll be on my way.
A condition I would be a fool to refuse. Of course, you shall have your audience.
I don't suppose you saw where the thieves went.
I did not, no. Though some discreet inquiries made on his lordship's behalf mean that I know where you might find them. The bandit's bed. Every ill-gotten coin in Dalamal is said to pass through that disreputable corner of the Valcroy.
And that's where I'm heading.
I shall speak to Lord Ignac in your absence, and arrange for an audience upon your triumphant return.
That will be very kind of you.
Farewell, and best of luck. It's a wonder the Republic tolerates the existence of the bandit's bed. You would have thought a few dozen good men might put an end to the problem. Then again, what commander would want to march his troop into the Valcroy?
Mr. Lubor says Drake's fang has fallen. Does that mean the furnace is going to stop working?
Maybe. So shut your trap and get that order forged while you still can.
Our hero returns. My ears are always open.
Come on.
company! Come on, lads, let's tear the bastard's head off!
This must be Ignac's luggage. Nothing seems to be damaged. All right. Let's get it back to Dalamel.
I hear I have you to thank for the return of my effects. What shall I call you, my good man?
Wyvern. Glad to make your acquaintance.
A formidable name indeed. Well, Wyvern, I appear to be in your debt. Redeem here tells me you wished for an audience. Is that all?
A few moments of your time should suffice, yes.
You're a peculiar fellow, Wyvern. All right, speak.
Master Wyvern was wondering if you could tell him about a certain single-edged sword you recently acquired.
Oh, a true work of art, that one. Karen drove me hard on the price, but I would have sold her Radim here to get my hands on that sword. It was made in the Outer Isles, far beyond the Twins, and is used exclusively by the practitioners of a unique school of swordsmanship. They believe no combat should ever exceed a single strike, and hone their blades to such perfection that none ever does. Each sword is made for that one perfect stroke, and for that stroke only. They crack upon a second blow. There's a brutal sort of beauty to it, really.
But how do they hone such an edge?
Fine question. Why, they use a whetstone, of course. Whetstones, rather. A whole array of them, ranging from the coarse to the fine. 10,000 licks with the sharpening stone, then 10,000 more. But it is the final stone which lends the blade its legendary sharpness. A mineral quite foreign to this great realm of ours. And that is the key. The secret ingredient. Wyvern, it occurs to me that my little lecture is hardly equal to services rendered. Take this, together with my regards. The very stone of which I spoke, far rarer among collectors than even the blade itself. And a far more fitting payment.
Thank you.
Pardon the intrusion, my lordship. However, it is long past time we prepared ourselves to depart.
So it is. I am locked in bitter competition with a rival collector of curiosities. I am one step ahead of the unstoppable unscrupulous scoundrel, but he is hard at my heels.
Are there many other collectors out there?
Too many to count, but only one do I consider my nemesis. Lord Byron Rosfield, and is a perennial thorn in my side.
I can imagine.
Farewell, Wyvern. May our paths cross again. Radim, we mustn't dawdle.
I think his lordship is rather taken with you, Master Wyvern. Thank you again for your assistance. Coming, my lordship. I'll be right there.
Trust Uncle Byron to find such an interesting rival. Now, let's see what Blackthorn makes of this whetstone, shall we?
Is that the thing Toes helped to build?
Yeah. He said it was some sort of...
Meg told me she was building a ship.
Goat. Still alive, I see. So Lady Karen accepted the ruby?
Ah. Oh, about that. I tried my best. But she was just too stubborn to take it. She threw it right back in my face, in fact. And told me I could stick my stupid stone where the sun don't shine.
Karen refused payment.
I hope it wasn't something I said.
I'm sure you were as tactful as ever. Let me see what I can do.
Oh, wonderful. I hope you have better luck than I did.
In case you've forgotten, Twinside's under siege. So don't be surprised if they're picking up.
Lady Karen, Goat tells me you weren't happy with our offer. Would you prefer the debt was repaid in coin?
What debt? I don't recall lending any of you lot me hard-earned gil. I may have tossed a talent or two in the Hideaway's coffers, but those were donations, and you can hardly call it charity if you go asking for it back.
Of course not. But one good turn deserves another, and our circumstances have changed. Surely you wouldn't shun the gratitude of a pauper who happened to have become a prince.
Oh, so you're a prince now, are you? Fine. But I'm selling it and taking what I'm owed, then you're getting the rest whether you like it or not. Where'd you even get this? A decent trader might nab 1,000 talents for a star ruby. A canny one, meanwhile, might claim it were nicked from the belt of Sid the Outlaw himself and ask twice as much. Might be I already have a buyer in mind. Might be you even know her. A fine continental maid whose beauty's only eclipsed by a guile in commerce. You wouldn't mind, would you?
Not at all. Just be sure to tell her that it's always a pleasure doing business.
I hear you ended up delivering all three stones. Thanks to this lump. I sometimes wonder what I pay you for.
Speaking of which, I still haven't been paid last month's wages.
Oh, so you remember what's owed to you then? Get your ass behind that disc of yours and don't get up before those ledges are square.
Right away.
I've seen that before.
Yeah. Plenty of times. It was the only goblet Sid ever used. Either out of habit, or because the filthy sod couldn't be bothered to find a clean one.
I knew so little about him.
Like most people.
Martha and the Dame both seem to have fond memories of him.
Huh. I bet they do.
How long did you know Sid before he...
Before he died. 20 summers, give or take. Back in the day, I was a purser on a trade ship, which is where I met him. He bought passage to, I forget where. But having nothing better to do on the long nights, we set up drinking island rum till the morning bell dragged me back to my duties. Quit my post not long after that, on account of making a fine maiden's belly fat. But me and Sid stayed close, promising we'd one day sail the seas again. That was before fate stepped in and said she was having none of it. The magic woke inside my son soon after his first name day, and there was no hiding his knack.
Couldn't you and your family have?
My family were the ones who summoned the constable. Wanted the monster taken away. I couldn't turn my back on him. Forget what I felt. And I couldn't for the life of me understand how they could. Luckily, Sid was of the same mind as me. It was him who stood beside me when all I wanted was to tear the whole world down. Him who cried for me when I had no tears left of my own. Him who swore he'd do everything he could to stop it from happening again. And he was true to his word, too. Left the Royal Army once and for all. His ranks, his ribbons, gone. Just like that. Threw away everything he had. All to right a wrong that no one else had the courage to face. I knew then I'd follow that man to the ends of the earth. Was always too clever for his own good, was Sid. Saw the world for what it really was, while the rest of us were content to go along with the lie we were shown. And it can't have been easy, bearing that burden alone. But he didn't let it stop him. He never lost faith in what he believed was right. And that gave us faith in him. Faith he'd steer us true. So I swore to myself that I'd always be right behind him, ready to catch the stubborn sod if ever he should fall. But I couldn't even do that.
Ignore me. Just the ramblings of a tired old man. Leave that lot. I'll tidy it up in a bit.
This is Sid's handwriting. Dear Otto.
I may be drunk, but I wanted you to know this place would be fucked without you. Love you, you grumpy old sod.
This note.
What about it?
Sid was right. Without you, we'd all be lost.
He should have bloody well said so then. Just once. Before he went. But then, why would he? Him, or anyone? I'd only have told him to piss off. You're wrong, though. Both of you. It was never just me keeping the hideaway afloat. It was all of us. I just shoved people in the right direction, and I barely seem to be able to do that anymore.
Would you rather go at the helm?
Well, maybe I've got a few more years left in me.
I'm going to hold you to that, Otto.
Before you go, Sid would have wanted you to have this.
But that's...
This will do me just fine. Thanks for the ray of sunshine. I'll see if I can't pay you back.
Already have.
You might want to give that thing a rinse. Can't claim it's what Sid would have wanted, but even he wasn't right about everything.
Mid told me she was building a ship.
Really? That's a ship.
Let's see. Ah, my favorite pupil.
Allow me to educate you. I have the details here. One must understand one's place in the world. Very good.
Is that the thing Tomes helped with?
I noticed you and Torgal had gone off somewhere. Took him for a walk, did you?
You could say that.
So, Molly's leftovers weren't good enough, eh? That'll teach me for treating you like you're still a pup. All right, no need to shout. Now we know what you're after, I can see about getting some in.
Speaking of which, I brought one for later. Can I leave it with you?
You can, aye. I'm nice like that. In return, you can thank Tomes for me. The bloody know-it-all.
I was just on my way to see him.
Ah, Clive. Were you able to locate your quarry?
We were indeed, Lawsman. You pointed us in exactly the right direction. And Torgal's been a very happy hound ever since.
Very good, very good.
Lady Karen sends her thanks, by the way, for your part in solving the mystery.
Ah. But that reminds me. After your last visit, I found myself pondering Torgal's talents. Do you recall our conversation concerning Lady Jill's role in Torgal's transformation?
About how she somehow woke the power within him.
Precisely that. A reasonable conclusion, I thought. But one which raised certain questions in my mind. You see, the Fenrir of legend served Shiva and Shiva alone. And while the powers attributed to him are certainly impressive, the records imply they are somewhat different in nature to those you describe Torgal as having used.
What are you suggesting?
That Torgal may be the beneficiary of more than one Icon's power. Consider that in addition to Lady Jill, he has served as a loyal companion to you, your brother, and even the late Cid. In short, the Icons hitherto near at hand, or should I say at paw, have been diverse and plenty, and that number has only grown as the realm's dominance have fallen to your sword. One can but speculate as to how all of this has affected Torgal.
He has seemed more fierce of late.
And if I am not mistaken, he will grow fiercer still. We are fortunate indeed to be able to count him amongst our allies and not our adversaries.
Oh, he's more than an ally. He's a friend.
Things to pack before I leave. I'll meet yous down in Buckland.
Sorry for the wait. But hopefully he'll agree it was worth it.
You learned something about that sword, then?
I did better than that.
A whetstone?
Yes. But not one you'll find anywhere in Valestia.
No wonder I couldn't get the same finish on the grinding wheel. One hit and all done, eh? Might not be so bad if all you ever fought were duels. Good luck on the battlefield. Your second opponent would be your last, no matter how good you were.
Even so, is there some way it could be used to give the Curse Breakers an edge?
I think so, yeah. With this whetstone and the right kind of steel, I could probably even make a twin of the blade to rattle me. But there'd be no replacing this little rock once I've worn it down to a sliver. I reckon we get a dozen swords from it, if that. Swords that the Curse Breakers wouldn't know how to wield properly, and that would see them through a single fire piece. Nah, no point trying to copy that thing. Be about as much use as a wax anvil. But finishing our blades with a whetstone this fine, now that's something to consider. And what's finer than fallen masonry, eh? Or more hard-wearing, for that matter? Just imagine it. Good Valestian steel with an edge as sharp as any found in the Outer Isles. I won't make a copy, nah. I'll make something much better.
I'm sure the Curse Breakers will be delighted. Just don't push yourself too hard.
Don't you worry about me, Sunshine. I've been working day and night since I was half your age, and I'll still be here when you're long gone. Hey, thanks, Clive. I mean it. I owe you one, August 2. It's good to know someone's looking out for me.
He'll be happy to hear you said that.
And I'll see that my debt to you's paid. First new blade I make's got your name on it. You come and find me when you've got the materials.
Right. I will.
So, will it be? It'd last you a good while. And?
What do I have to eat to grow as tall as you, Mr. Still? Thank you.
wish I could take that about the...
All right there, Sid. How's that hunt for the bomb ash going?
I have it here.
That's the stuff. And plenty of it, too. Enough to keep the alembic bubbling away for a good old while. You're a gent, Sid. Let nothing say otherwise. Right then. Let's get this contraption up and running. There we have it. The Telemon Alembic. And it works just like the chief said it would.
Very impressive.
Says the man who cut down a burning boulder. Speaking of which, I still haven't returned a favor.
There's no need. The good it will do for the hideaway is reward enough.
Don't be silly. Why don't you let me take a look at that bag of yours? The one you keep your potions in. Reckon I could work some magic on that, huh?
What kind of magic?
Well, we happen to have isolated a substance in our test run of the alembic that I reckon will make even the toughest lever supple as anything. Thought we might use it to breathe new life into old boots and the like. Save the hideaway a few gil. But I reckon if we slap a bit on your bag, it'll loosen it up enough for you to squeeze in a bottle or two more.
Well, it can't hurt to try, I suppose.
That's the spirit! Leave it with me. I'll only be a mo. Well? What do you reckon?
It certainly feels more flexible.
Right. Told you.
Thank you. I think.
No. Thank you for supporting Mid and the rest of us in our endeavors. Without you, we'd never have been able to discover wonders like that stuff I rubbed on your back. And I'm telling you, there's plenty more where that came from. Leather loosener was only the first of the discoveries the Alembic's gonna help us make. Just you wait, Sid. Just you wait!
How are you doing? Anything catch your eye? Always something in there.
Oh, I wasn't expecting you back so soon. Here you are. Best of luck out there, Sid.
Told me she was building a ship.
Is that the thing Tomes helped to build?
Is it business or pleasure? If you're gonna buy something, be quick about it. It'd better all be here. You're rubbing me blind, you know. You'll not find a better price than that. Finished, are you?
Crystal too.
It's no joke. Drake's fan is gone.
Ready, girl?
I see the Dalmechs lag behind Rosaria when it comes to bridge building.
The fallen ruin should hold, at least. The path continues on the other side.
Ah!
Good girl. So this is Amekis.
The land of the gods. It's even more impressive than I imagined. I remember being captivated by the story as a child.
Long, long ago, man was overcome by avarice and challenged the gods in a bid to win their power. A final battle took place here, at these falls. Or so the legend goes. If anyone ever manages to plumb those depths, perhaps we'll learn if there's any truth to the tale.
That the gods emerged victorious and punished man for his defiance by visiting upon him two curses.
Dominance and bearers. Tell the truth. I always thought it strange that the dominant and their icons were deemed a curse. Back home, the dominant inherited the throne. They were admired and exalted, not spurned. Whenever I got to that part of the story, I always assumed there must be something I'd misunderstood.
You had a lot of storybooks, didn't you? In your room, I mean. When we were young.
The old legends were always my favorites. Epic battles between gods and men. Father encouraged me to read as much as I could. He thought it good for my education.
You really were a boy like any other, weren't you?
Just look at this place. It's enough to make you believe the legends are true.
I know.
We're not far from Boklad. The road will be busier up ahead.
Then we'll have to keep our wits about us. Clive? Something wrong?
Nothing. It's nothing.
I see the reports are true, Father. You have surrendered the throne to Olivier.
I have. Emperor Olivier shall rebuild the Holy Empire of Sambrek.
How is he to rule an empire? He is but a boy.
I shall advise him until he comes of age.
Father, please.
Or for as long as I am able. The empire we seek to build needs young blood to rule it. And I can think of none better suited to the task. There is other news, Dion. Hugo Kupka is dead, and Drake's Fang destroyed. The pillars of the Republic have fallen. Ere long, the Imperial banner shall fly over every city in storm. And then, Valisthea. All shall bow before their Emperor.
Father, these are the words of a tyrant.
They are the words of a god. the Emperor whom I gladly serve. Great Grieger, made flesh. Return to your camp, Dion, and ready your forces. It is time to show the world the true power of Sambrek.
Father. I find you much changed. Is this truly the path you wish to tread? Or are these the ambitions of another? Of Ultima, perhaps?
What nonsense is this? I speak my mind, and my mind only. Though I do owe Annabella thanks for reminding me of certain truths. Regarding the nature of nations, of rulers, and of the divine.
You trust the words of this traitress? She betrayed her country! She slew her husband!
You have ever been an invaluable servant to Sambrek, Prince Dion. I trust you will continue to serve your Emperor in the wars to come.
The canker!
Silence! Insolent wretch! You will bend the knee. All else is heresy.
Sire, forgive me.
This audience is over. Come, your radiance. The Rowena Syndicate awaits your pleasure.
Oh, not another meeting with silly old men. They're so boring. I'm hungry, Father. Can't we have luncheon instead?
Does it pain you that you will not inherit your father's throne?
I have suffered worse.
Count your blessings, Dion. For a base-born child to be chosen by Bahamut is miracle enough. You have risen high on his wings, but you shall rise no higher, lest your impure blood stain the throne.
What do you know of my blood?
Boklab markets are to the north. We just need to hug the coast. The wind.
Infiltrating the Dominion won't be easy with the Imperials on high alert.
No. His Radiance has lost one capital already. We can be sure Sylvester will do everything in his power to hold on to Twinside. His troops are well trained and increasingly battle-hardened. damage to it.
My turn!
Nice try.
They've closed the road to Randalar.
If the siege breaks, they'll need more than this to stop the Imperial legions marching on the capital.
Oh, I'm done for. If I can't get these goods to Randalar, how will I pay for my bread?
We'll just have to beg for it, like everyone else fleeing the fall of the Fang. Oh, world's gone to hell.
If you haven't got a pass, you're not getting through.
Please! I'm begging you!
Headed over to the Crystalline Dominion too, are you? There's good gil to be made there, believe you me. Yeah, the minute I heard them bandits had blown up Drake's Fang, I packed up me store and pulled me boots on. And so did you, eh? I did have a plan to make me fortune with some baths down by the Dalamil Inn. How can anybody sit back and relax in a land that ain't got a whiff of the Crystal's blessing no more? And that's when it hit me. If you're looking for lucre, the Dominion's the place to be. Soon enough, half a storm will be headed there. If I can get in first and set up shop, I'll have a license to mint gil. The guildmasters of Canver will be beggars by comparison. I'll be famous in all four corners of Storm soon enough, and I'll have a fortune that'll make me ma and pa proud.
No much further to Bogdad now.
Good. I've had my fill of life without magic, if you can call it life. The sooner I can fill my flask from a crystal like a civilized adult, the better.
Run like the wind.
Without the crystal's blessing.
next girl.
Stay down!
There are no crystals here. We have to keep going. The crystalline dominion is our only chance.
I know, but the checkpoint. This is where we're supposed to meet Goots, isn't it?
That's right. He said he'd wait for us here after replenishing his supplies. I dare say he'll have finished by now.
For the Dominion post haste.
I am hurrying, my lord.
Bloody Crimson Caravan scooping up all the best customers. Leave some for the rest of us.
I wish to engage the Crimson Caravan's services. Where's the proprietress?
She's otherwise engaged at present, my lord. Come back later.
Had brought any coin with them, we'd be rich.
Drake's Fang's fallen, would you believe it? No wonder everyone's taken to the road.
That's not all. I heard Lord Kupka fell too. The Republic's not long for this world, if you ask me.
I hear the brothers found another victim. Can you believe it?
I believe it, all right. What's that?
Soldier like yourself could do with hearing this. If ever you see a couple of brothers up in Leighton's Cleft, you just pass them right on by.
And why is that?
because they're duplicitous bastards who make cutthroats and footpads look like upstanding citizens by comparison. What they do is befriend a passing merchant, someone new to the area, and steer them straight into the arms of bandits. The merchant dead and his murderers busy bickering over the poor bastard's wares, the brothers set to sweet-talking some other unsuspecting fool, a warrior. Now, the brave soul charges into the footpad's den thinking he's doing the realm a favour, and when he's done, the brothers sweep in and loot the bandits and dead merchant both.
Yeah, there's a lazy sort of cunning to it, I suppose. You'd think they'd run out of bandits eventually.
So close to Boglad?
Not bloody likely.
I suppose you're right. Anyway, if you run into them, you steer clear. Or better yet, give them a damn good hiding.
I really wish I had. Thanks for the warning.
Crimson caravans scooping up all the customers. Leave some for the rest of us.
What are you looking for?
Many thanks. Fine choice. You've a discerning eye. Many thanks. Farewell.
Let me carry your goods. I'm cheap.
And nasty. Let me, my lord. You won't regret it.
This is everything. It must be transported to the Dominion without delay, no matter the cost.
Certainly, madam. I'll see that our fastest bird is made ready.
What do you think, girl? Is it time we took to the Crystal Road ourselves?
For hire, best service at the best price. Others will carry off your fortune, I'll just carry your goods.
That's that then. No trader's pass, no passage.
Peaches and pears, beets and beans.
Wonders from across the water. Come one, come all. Feast your eyes. Good sir, can I interest you in...
How much? For a measly crust of bread?
You won't find any cheaper, not nowadays. But you're more than welcome to look.
The Empire's unlawful and illegitimate occupation of the Crystalline Dominion is still in effect. Only those whose business in Twinside has been officially approved by the Republican Army will be permitted to cross the border. All who seek entry are to form a line and ready their documents for inspection.
It looks like we aren't the only ones who are eager to leave.
And they're checking everyone.
Can't you make an
exception? Not for the likes of you.
We won't get through without that pass. Let's go and find Goot, shall we? He must be around here somewhere.
Oh, my peaches! They're sweet as nectar!
Have you got a trader's pass? No? Then fuck off.
Let us through!
Remember when half the people coming through here were traders from the Empire?
Aye. Now not even our own want to stick around.
Go and bother someone else, will you? I've got my trader's pass and I'll be leaving as soon as I'm able. If I stay here much longer, I'll end up no better off than those poor sods by the gates.
You should come with me to the Dominion. Life will be different there.
You won't find anything of this quality in Twinside.
Goot. There you are.
Clive, I'm so sorry. Don't tell Nan, will you?
Slow down, Goot. Just tell us what happened.
It's me trader's pass. It's gone. We cannot ride the caravan without it. We won't even be able to get through the flipping checkpoint.
Do you remember when you last saw it?
It was in me pocket a minute ago. Then a bairn bumped into me and... Yeah. You don't think that they might have nicked it, do you?
It wouldn't surprise me. A busy market like this is prime territory for pickpockets.
So, to get the pass back, we need to find this child. Where would we even start?
I know where! I've got a pal in Bocklad who might be able to help us. No one knows more about what goes on round here than she does.
Where do we find her?
She's the owner of the Crimson Caravans, up that way.
Sounds got a red chocobo on it.
No time like the present.
You two go on ahead. I'm gonna check the rest of me stuff, make sure no one else is missing.
All right. We'll meet you there.
Go to the Crimson Caravans and ask for the owner. It's the place with the red chocobo on the sign. Big red chocobo.
Let's keep an eye out for this red chocobo, then.
And the other on our purses.
Next to the checkpoint. Show them your trader's pass, and you'll be on your way.
If you're looking for the Crimson Caravans, head out of the canyon and take the first road to your right. But if it's a bowl you're after... No? People only ever want directions.
Peaches and pears, beets and beans.
Out of my sight, wretch. I've no use for a brandy who can't even fill my cup.
Looking to hire a coach? It's 10 million for a two-birder to the Crystalline Dominion. Take it or leave it.
Oh, we're not here for that.
Then I bid you good day.
Oh, wait! Don't go, El! He's me mate!
As I live and breathe. Goots, what are you doing back in Bocklad? I gather Lady Karen didn't send you. So what trouble have you got yourself into this time?
It's me trader's pass. It got stolen. By little Ben.
Of all the... You're the size of a marble. Honestly. Goots told us that you know the markets well. Might you have an idea which little Ben could have done this?
We don't intend to punish them. We just need our pass back. Ben, we can be on our way.
I see. So neither of you has a trader's pass either. Not that anyone would take you for traders, but I suppose that's why you came to me, correct? Now, I can't say for sure who took your pass, but I suspect I know why they did it. Let me explain.
Ever since the Fist marched on the Dominion, the Republic has been clamping down on any commerce that might aid the Empire more than it does us. Which means traders' passes have gone from being merely a way of easing one's progress to being essential if one wishes to cross the border at all. And with demand outstripping supply, they've become a precious commodity, leading some to seek to acquire them by less than legitimate means.
So the children are stealing passes to sell on the black market?
Yes, and no. Passes are inscribed with the names of their owners, and yet none of the victims' names have appeared on the register of those passing through the checkpoint.
Which means?
That someone is doctoring the stolen passes. The same someone who is encouraging the children to steal them. And the same someone who has Goots's pass, no doubt. Whoever they are, they're ruining the livelihoods of honest merchants, which is why we've decided to take a stand. Will you stand with us? You want to get your pass back, and we want to ensure that no more are stolen. Catch whoever's behind it all, and two birds shall be slain with a single stone.
Is there any other way of getting to the Crystalline Dominion, Goots?
They won't let you in if you're not with the caravan. It's that, I don't know, try swimming across the strait. But the guards will definitely spot you if you try and do that. Like, we don't want to get spotted, right?
So either we find the people who took the pass, or give up all hope of entering the Dominion.
All right. We'll help.
Thank you kindly. Yeah, but I don't know your name. Eloise at your service.
Clive.
A pleasure doing business with you, Clive. The proprietor of the furniture makers by the coach stop is spearheading the search. Wear that, and he will know you for a friend. I suggest that you speak with him first.
The furniture makers. Understood.
We've formed something of a merchant's guild to get to the bottom of our pickpocketing problem. The furniture maker by the coach stop is gathering the reports.
I looked through the rest of my stuff, and no else was missing, just me pass. But that was the only thing that really mattered. We can't ride the caravan without it. And it's not as if I'm getting another. It was hard enough getting this one. Oh, please, Clive, you've got to help us get it back. You're my only hope.
Out of my sight, wretch.
Jug of snake spit for the road.
Are you the furniture maker?
Looking for something in particular? Ah,
In a way, he's collared you too, eh? Then I expect you want to know more.
She told me you were leading the hunt for the pickpockets. What have you learned?
For one, that they're targeting the traders carrying the biggest packs. Harder to watch your back, see? And less chance of the mark giving chase if they're spotted. Not that they'd be likely to catch them. Those imps know every inch of this warren like the backs of their hands.
Their eyes must have lit up when they saw Goots.
The fishmonger round by the gate's been trying to track down the children involved. You should go and have a word with her.
Thank you. We will.
Have a word with the fishmonger back there, by the gate. She's been looking into who the culprits might be.
You won't find anything of this quality in Twinside.
You should come with me to the Dominion. Life will be different.
Fish for sale! Fresh sorted and smoked! Can I interest you in...
Ah, sorry. Message from Eloise, is it?
She's asked me to help her. To help you find the pickpockets.
Is that so? Suppose I better tell you what I know, then. For one, this isn't a family operation. All the traders say the children who stole their passes were dirty, dressed in rags. Street urchins, by the sound of it. We get a lot around here.
Orphans from the wars.
A few, perhaps. You saw the refugees gathered by the entranceway? They're all looking for a new start in the Dominion and beyond. Some of them take it as an opportunity to rid themselves of unwanted baggage.
The shame of it.
Whoever's behind this would have to have made themselves known to the children at some point.
And so should we.
You should start with the children around here, then. I doubt they're the ones involved, but they might have heard something.
It's worth a try.
All right, then. Questioning children. How hard can that be?
The little scamps you'll see running around here might be naughty, but I don't see any of them being involved in this. Still, they might have heard something. Can't hurt to ask.
You should come with me to the Dominion. Life will be different there.
Come, taste my peaches! They're sweet as nectar!
Excuse me, do you mind if I ask you something?
Can't stop you.
I was just wondering if anyone has asked you to do anything out of the ordinary recently.
Anything you grown-ups ever ask us to do is shut up and go away. So guess what I'm about to tell you to do?
Sorry. I'll leave you alone.
Oh, just leave me alone.
I'll take the large one.
An excellent choice, my lord.
Do you have a moment?
What do you want?
What I want is to know who's asking children like you to pick pockets.
I don't know. Nobody's asked me. What's picking pockets? Do you get paid for it?
No, you get in trouble for it. So if they come calling, you know what to tell them.
I picked a hole in my pocket once. Is that bad too?
The caravan stops next to the checkpoint.
Jug of snake spit for the road?
Excuse me.
What do you want? I don't have any money.
It's all right. We're not going to hurt you. We just want to talk.
What about?
We've heard that some very bad people are making children like you steal from travelers. We need to know who's behind it so we can stop them.
I don't know much about it, really. But my friend, Honza, he said he got a job doing something dangerous.
Sounds promising.
We need to find him and ask.
Do you know where your friend might be?
He's usually by the tent outside town.
Thank you. You've been very helpful.
He'll probably be by the tents. You won't hurt him, will you?
Jug of snake spit.
Come one, come all!
Peaches and pears.
Let me carry your goods. I'm cheap. Porter for hire. Best
service. That's that then. No traders pass.
She must have been the refugee camp.
Let's hope he's still nearby.
There are no crystals here. We have to keep going.
That big fat donkey was easy pickings. He wouldn't have noticed if we'd robbed his boots off him.
Yeah. Wish we hadn't handed over the pass, though. Could use one of those things to get out of this dump.
Chance would be a fine thing. The moment they found out, they'd string us up by our guts.
Would they now? Perhaps you'd like to introduce us to these charming characters.
Shit! We're in trouble now!
What do we do?
You two get caught if you want. I'm off.
Hansa, where are you going?
So that was Hansa, eh? Jill, you watch these two. I'm going after him.
All right.
He can't have gone far. I need to find him before his employers do.
I'll watch these two. You go after Hansa.
Daddy! I'm
hungry. That's that, then.
Did you see a boy run past? He stole something from a friend of mine.
There was a boy ran back there towards the chocobo pen, but...
Thank you.
The chocobo pen's back there. I don't know if it's the same lad who stole from you, but that's where he was headed. Choice.
I'm looking for the people who are making you steal for them. Who are they?
Call themselves the Carstones. They said they'd give me good gil if I did what they told me. I knew they were bad, but bread doesn't come for free. Didn't come at all half the time before I started buzzing for them. You know, if I didn't do it, they'd just pick on someone else. Someone they could push around easier.
Hansa.
You found him, then?
Jill. Where are the other two?
Eloise is watching over them. She sent Gutz and I to look for you.
You're... him!
I haven't got your pass anymore, if that's what you're after. I gave it to the Carstones. Whatever you do to me, I can't get it back. Not that I go against them, anyway. If it weren't for their gil, me and my mates would have starved.
Cowards! You will not force another child to do your bidding.
Wait, we're not-
Don't hurt him!
You're making a mistake. We're on the same side.
Like hell we are. That brooch. Where did you get it?
Master Theo?
Goots. What are you doing with these people? Unless you're the ones my sister was talking about.
Your sister? Eloise didn't tell us she had a brother.
And why would she? I'm just her back and a blade. Theodore, at your service. Sorry about before.
Theodore, what do you know of the cast stones?
Vultures who have made Balklad their hunting ground. They prey on the desperate, stealing from those with Gil and bullying those without it into joining their flock. I'd been looking into their activities in hope of sparing the refugees any further hardship. But it seems they've already stooped even lower than I'd feared. Hansa's a good lad. Don't blame him for what they've made him do. If he and his friends hadn't agreed to work for the stones, some other poor souls would have. On pain of death, most likely. Clive, was it? And my sister's asked you to help put an end to the pickpocketing. Then we all want the same thing.
Is it?
I'm sorry.
So, what's the plan?
What else? We find the cast stones and we crush them. You get your trader's pass back. And I make Balklad a safe place again.
All right, then.
All right, then. Hansa, where are they camped? Don't worry. They'll never know you told us.
Couldn't if I wanted to. They always come to town to collect the passes. Meet us outside the gate. I tried following them once, but they spotted me halfway down the trail. Said they'd string me up.
We'll try it this time. Which way were they going?
Back down the road towards Leighton's Cleft.
To Leighton's Cleft, then.
Leighton's Cleft is to the south, past the camp.
It looked like they were about to turn into Leighton's Cleft before they spotted me.
You can do it, Clive!
That's that, then. No traders pass. No passage.
the one who's been sticking his nose in our business.
You should have minded your own.
You're finished.
I doubt these were the ringleaders.
But at least we know we're on the right track.
Today, eh?
Aye. Some of our new recruits are natural-born ne'er-do-wells.
Especially the little ones. That Hans has got nimble fingers, all right.
It'll be a shame when they chop them off. But till then, let's make the most of it.
Scum.
The leaders of the cast stones, I take it.
They don't deserve any mercy, Clive.
I wasn't planning on showing them any.
We're ready when you are, Theodore.
Oh, I'm ready.
Fuck! That guard from Bokmat! Kill him! Kill them all! Awakened winds!
And they say crime doesn't pay. Gold chains, rings, purses. Ah, and traders' passes. Dozens of them.
Have the names been changed?
Not yet. I recognize some of them. No doubt Gootz's is somewhere among them. Now I just need to sort through it all and return everything to the people it was taken from.
We should go and give Eloise the good news. Can we leave things here in your hands, Theodore?
Of course. Oh, and, be sure to tell her of the part I played, won't you?
We'll be glad to. No need to ride from here.
There are no crystals here.
Daddy, I'm hungry.
That's that then.
Clive, how goes the hunt? My brother isn't getting in your way, I trust?
Quite the opposite.
So it was the cast stones who were behind it all. Theo told me he'd been on their trail. And their demise solves three problems at a stroke. That of the pickpockets, the bandits pulling their strings, and the passes they were stealing. I only hope yours is among the items you recovered. Only time and Theo's return will tell. Speaking of whom, welcome home, dear brother.
You are too kind, Eloise. Here, Clive, Goods's pass. Ask him to keep a closer eye on it from now on, would you?
I will. Thank you.
El, I've asked our boys to carry the rest of the goods back. Can I count on your help in sorting through it all?
Of course. I'll make some space in the storeroom. I expect you'll soon be on your way then. But it wouldn't do to leave without introducing yourself properly, would it now? Sid. Don't look so shocked. We're on the same side.
I don't understand.
As you now know all too well, we at the Crimson Caravans are always happy to help those in need. For a small fee, we will move anything that needs moving. Be that goods to market, or bearers away from it.
I was the first my sister helped escape. If it wasn't for her, I'd have been branded as a boy.
I had no idea.
It just so happens that we are seeking to expand our operation. And who better to join forces with than the leader in the field? Wouldn't you agree, Theo?
I would. It seems our purpose is the same in more ways than one. So what would you say to working together again?
It would be our pleasure.
And our honor. The honor is ours.
Here, Clive. This is for you.
What is it?
El has friends in high places, while I have associates in, lower ones. That mark is proof that you're a friend to us both.
I shall bear it with pride.
Well, all that remains is to wish you a safe onward journey. Goots's pass should secure you a place on the caravan, but if you encounter any difficulties, we would be delighted to provide you with a coach of our own. For a discounted price, of course. Say, 9 million?
We'll try the caravan. Let's get this back to Goots.
And then it's on to the Dominion.
Is something the matter? Why, I am what you see. It can be a risky business. This being a border town. Or at least, it did. Don't worry about Honza and the others. Safe travels.
Anything I can do for you? And I wouldn't have it any other way. All the better. Fools, the lot of them. Criminals and cowards. So thank you. You're always welcome at the caravans.
Bloody cruise and caravan. Scooping up all the best customers. Leave some for the rest of us.
Our new arrivals had brought any.
Now I just need to see about getting the word out to everyone. They'll want to know right away.
Bad news.
Good, actually. Something worth celebrating for a change. Only trouble is, the serving girl's still new to the job, so I can't leave her while I go and invite those I'd like to celebrate with.
What exactly are you celebrating, if you don't mind me asking?
I've come by a particularly fine bottle of red. A Gotan 66, no less. Gotan Rouge is the only good thing to have ever come out of the Empire. And most wouldn't part with a 66 if you held a knife to their throats.
So I've heard.
Oh, so you know of it then. Clearly you're a gentleman of taste. A gentleman who might sympathize with my predicament, perhaps? Would you pass the good news to a few friends of mine? I'll give you a little something for your time, of course.
Sounds simple enough.
So you'll do it. Marvelous. Thank you. You won't need to go far. All three of them should be right here in the market. There's Aldrich the Porter, Milan the Butcher, and Bollock, a guard over at the North Gate. Three of the finest fellows in Bocklad, if you ask me. Tell them to come to the tavern when they finish for the day. Stop by again when you let them know, and I'll give you your little something.
I'll be right back.
There are plenty of hard-working folk here in Bocklad, but my three friends deserve a tipple more than most. You let them know there's a cup of fine wine waiting for them when they're ready.
I've been asked to find Aldrich, the porter. I don't suppose that's you, is it?
That's me, right enough. You need something delivered?
The innkeeper sent me. He said there's a cup of Gotan 66 with your name on it when you're done for the day.
A 66? Look at me. If he's just got hold of it now, it must have been in the crates he had me carry down from Sambrek.
From the Empire to Bocklad. You must be a braver man than most. That's a treacherous route at the best of times.
Such is the porter's lot. There's not a patch of storm these feet haven't traipsed across. They'd Soraflam one day, then off to Canva the next. The farther you're willing to go, the fatter the purse. which is why there's no shortage of competition for some of the longer routes. I'd say I've done enough for today to earn myself a cup of something tasty. Thanks for letting me know. Most men would keep a fine vintage like a Gotan 66 to themselves. But not our innkeeper. He's a true gent, no one.
I see you've been of some assistance to Eloise. Perhaps you can extend me the same kindness?
Perhaps. What would I be doing?
Finding someone. You see, I've been having trouble with thieves, and despite the many pains I've taken, I can't stop them from rummaging through my packs. I was griping about my lot to a friend of mine a few days back, and he offered to track the culprits down. Now, Joseph's a sellsword, and a good one at that. But he's been gone days, and I'm beginning to fear the worst.
Any idea where his search for the thieves might have taken him?
The old Zemeckis Road, perhaps? He doubted they would be fool enough to linger here in Boklad. Joseph's lived a hard life. Made him grey long before his time. I just pray he hasn't been killed over a few sacks of grain.
I can't imagine there are too many grey-haired sellswords around. Hopefully someone will have seen him.
Whatever left poor Joseph Grey didn't leave him jaded. Kind-hearted man like him doesn't deserve to meet his end, chasing thieves.
Pardon me, but would you happen to be a fighting man, perchance? That well-notched steel and impressive physique. I have need of a sword for hire. And yours looks to be a weapon well worth the coin. Might you be convinced to offer me the use of those formidable arms?
How exactly do you intend to use them?
Well, being something of a scholar of Zemeckian history, I wish to investigate the ruins near the city. And I require a rugged companion, lest I find myself waylaid by ne'er-do-wells or the beasts said to roam the area. Should you accept, you will not only earn yourself material wealth, but partake of the true treasure that awaits us there. The rich and storied history of Zemeckis. Well, were you ever party to a finer proposition?
My arms are yours.
Wonderful! Then come! We must away.
But where are we going?
Along the old Zemeckis Road, and from there, onward to Discovery. Quickly! There is not a moment to lose!
Wait. Good luck with your ne'er-do-wells. I'd better make sure he doesn't get himself killed.
Let me carry your goods. I'm cheap!
Peaches and pears! Beets and beans!
What do you want? I've no coin on me.
Just information. Has a sellsword passed through here? Grey hair.
Now you mention it, there was a young man with salt in his mane sneaking around out there a while back.
Which way did he go?
How am I supposed to know? Buggered off down the road, I expect. Now why don't you do the same and leave me be?
Why am I not surprised?
You'll hand over your coin if you know what to do. Happily not, good sir. Thanks to your timely intervention. More importantly, we have arrived. Now, feast your eyes upon the marvel before us. Ruins, a relic of the fallen civilization. A sight so common that man is oft blinded to its wonder. Colossal vessels, dashed from the very heavens. Airships, we call them. With very little thought to what wonders such a word might describe. Oblige me if you would. Does anything strike you as peculiar about this particular specimen? Though we ourselves find fallen ruins to be nigh indestructible, whatever gouged the final sin from the rock cleaved clean through the structure you see before you. A tantalizing mystery, no doubt, but merely one of countless enigmas in which Zemeckian history is steeped. Come, good sir. Our expedition continues, and we still have much to learn.
He's passionate. I'll give him that.
We don't want any trouble.
Neither do I. I'm looking for someone. A gray-haired mercenary.
Well, we haven't seen him.
Yes, we have. We saw him climbing up the rocks. Those ones, over there.
Maybe he found his thieves.
Mum won't let me near them. She said there's goblins up there, and that they eat little boys for dinner.
Shush now. You've said quite enough already.
I only told him what you said.
I'd listen to your mother if I were you. Joseph's thieves really lugged their stolen wares all the way out here. I think we've found our thieves. They don't look happy to see me.
Thank you.
Let's get this over with.
Stop! Don't kill him, he's just protecting his home.
Joseph? So the boy was right?
I don't know you.
Your porter friend sent me to find you. She was worried you might have got yourself killed.
Have I been gone that long? Wasn't hard finding the thieves. The problem was knowing what to do with them when I did.
I take it things are more complicated than they appear.
I'd all but ruled out bandits before I even left the market. You know why that is? Because our thieves had no interest in gold or gems or anything they couldn't eat, for that matter. Add to that the rumors of goblins in the area and the mystery practically solved itself. I soon found their cozy little homestead and all the missing food. I launched myself at them, full of righteous fury, but their leader was the only one who moved to meet me. The others, they huddled around that food, ready to die protecting it. They stole because it was that or starvation. I've been there myself, back when times were hard.
So you spared them, and earned their trust into the bargain by the look of it.
These goblins aren't native to the area. They don't know how to survive such barren lands, so I've been teaching them. And once they've learned to hunt and forage, they won't be fool enough to risk their necks in Boglad.
I'm impressed. I didn't know goblins could be reasoned with.
Do me a favor. Let the porter know I'm safe. I'll head back to the market once my work here is done. Oh, and don't mention the goblins. I don't want people coming here brandishing pitchforks. Not now this lot have sworn off thieving.
Your secret's safe with me.
I appreciate it. Thank you. I'd always thought of goblins as mindless savages. But if I'm honest, I like them better than half the men I've served with.
Good girl.
Faster!
Not again.
All right then. Who's first?
To get yourself killed.
Oh, that would not do. That would not do at all. Not when such majesty stretches out before us. Behold, a final sin in all its glory. As Moss tells us, a battle was fought here in ancient times, A battle of such ferocity that it tore a great crater in the very land upon which it was waged. In reaching for their holy sanctum, did man enrage the gods, and great was the vengeance that was rained down upon him. Alas, the full truth of the matter is lost to time, though I live in hope that I might see it discovered. But we must not dwell upon such things. There is more yet to see. Onward! History awaits!
Let's go.
Still in one piece?
It would seem so. Once more I am in your debt, and once more you impress me with your prowess. These were no ordinary foes, but ones we in the field call echoes. Though Moss the Chronicler concurs with the legends in attributing the fall of Zemeckis to a wrath wrought upon mankind by the gods, he offers little in the way of explanation. Could the ruins we see before us here, in all their elaborate beauty, perhaps suggest an answer? Could the construction of such miraculous edifices have been considered an encroachment upon the province of the divine? Alas, all is mere speculation. But one day, perhaps, I will learn the truth.
Not if you keep running headfirst into trouble.
You are right, of course. And not only have you plucked me repeatedly from the jaws of death, you have proven yourself a willing audience to my ramblings.
Glad to help, but didn't you say you came here to investigate something?
I fear I may have rather overstated the case on that front. In truth, a captive ear was all I really desired. You see, even my fellow scholars have grown somewhat weary of my musings of late, and so I came upon the idea of purchasing a companion. A captive audience, if you will.
That's what this was all about.
I am afraid so. And now, my good man, it is high time we returned whence we came.
Fine. Just don't go running off this time.
And so ends a delightful day. Here, your reward for humoring my selfish whims, plus a little extra for the trouble I have put you to. Truly, knowledge is a gift all the greater when shared. Thank you, once again.
Let me carry your goods. I'm cheap.
And nasty. Let me. Come on, come all!
Are you Milan, the butcher?
That's me. What can I do for you?
The innkeeper's just had a special delivery. He thought you might like to join him for a cup of wine after you pack up for the day.
He knows me only too well. And I've got a ham here that will go handsomely with a nice drop.
Wine and ham to spare. Barclad clearly isn't suffering, then.
Comes with being the place everyone has to pass through to get to everywhere else. Those who travel the Crystal Road bring all manner of goods with them. We get meat from Sanbrec, herbs from Rosaria. Why, sometimes we even see curiosities from across the Narrow. My old man knew what he was about when he set up shop here all those years ago. Anyway, thanks for the good news. Oh, you know what? Maybe I'll shut up shop early. Wouldn't want to keep our friend waiting. I've been keeping a cut of something special by for just such an occasion.
You won't find anything of this quality in Twinside.
Tight-fisted swines. And they act like it's the end of the world.
Get us through!
I'm looking for Bolek. I was told he'd be guarding the gate.
Well, you've found him. You're not here to enlist, I take it?
The innkeeper sent me. He's just taken delivery of a rare vintage. A Gotan 66. He thought you might like a cup.
I've never said no to a goat hand. I'm not about to start now. Thanks for letting me know.
You must be a busy man.
The market would be flooded with refugees if we weren't here to stem the flow. Oh, my heart goes out to them, all right, but we've got our orders. No papers, no passage. Plenty try to slip past us nonetheless. And every now and then, one of them's foolish enough to try and force their way through. And when they do, well, things can get nasty. You know what? That wine's sounding better by the moment.
Well done. I wonder if the innkeeper might spare a cup of that wine.
There's nothing like a good drink to drown your sorrows. No one knows sorrow like us gate guards.
The Empire's your enemy. Come, taste my peaches! They're sweet.
You won't find anything of this quality in Twinside.
Caravan stops next to the check.
Jug of snake spit for the road.
Come on, come all!
Peaches and pears. Peaches.
Out of my sight, wretch.
If our new arrivals had brought any coin with them.
I spoke to your friends. They'll be along soon.
That's fantastic news. Thank you kindly. It's been a while since we all sat down together. And the way I see it, that wine is as much theirs as it is my own.
How so?
Well, I wouldn't be serving anything but slops without Aldrich to go and fetch the good stuff for me. And then there's Milan, who always sends customers my way. And Bolek, an even-handed keeper of the peace, if ever there was one. Those three are the backbone of Barclad. Lose any one of them, and the market would soon fall apart. And without the market, I wouldn't have a single customer. I'd say that's worth a bottle of 66, wouldn't you?
And more besides.
Everyone needs a shoulder to lean on, be they world-weary innkeepers or brooding swordsmen. Right, I'd better prepare for my guest's arrival.
I hear you had me carrying a bottle of Gotan 66.
If I'd have known, I would have sold the thing and lived like a lord. I'll settle for a cup, though, if you're in a sharing mood.
A Gotan 60 bloody six. Just as well I had something special of my own set aside.
A bottle between the four of us might not be enough to drown our sorrows.
But it can't hurt.
Here they are, the three pillars of Boklad. Sit yourselves down, gentlemen. The woes of the world may be monstrous in many, but there's nothing like a few good friends to keep the misery at bay.
Never a truer word spoken.
Sod. For a handful of coins at that.
Ah, you were right to stay your bastard captain's hand. More bloodshed is the last thing we need in these dark days.
I owe these remarkable gentlemen more than a few paltry cups of wine. Even if it is the finest wine in all of Velisphere.
Oh, there's nothing like a cup or five of good wine to wash away the aches of the road. Post-haste.
I am hurrying, my lord.
Joseph's fine. He'll be back once he's tied up a few loose ends.
That's a weight off my shoulders.
He certainly knows his business. He found your thieves all right. And I dare say they won't be coming back.
A good man to have around, that Joseph. And if he says there'll be no more thieving, that's good enough for me. Thank you for putting my mind at ease. Here, for your troubles. No doubt Joseph had quite the adventure. I look forward to hearing all the details when he gets back.
Hugo Kupka's dead, isn't he? We don't have to live in fear of him anymore.
Is that the thing Tomes helped to build?
He cracked the crystal too.
told me she was building a ship.
How may I help you today, Clive? Best of luck out there, Sid.
Fancy a look at the list, do you?
Here you go.
Think you can help?
Let me carry your goods.
I'm out of my sight.
Caravan stops.
Juicy pears! Slake your
thirst! Did you hear about the Empire's black shields? Apparently they've been going around Imperial lands stringing up bearers.
Huh. What a waste!
What I really want to be is a blacksmith.
You're gonna do an apprenticeship or something, then?
Here you are, good. Try not to lose it again.
Me pass! You found it! Oh, thank you so much. Nan would have killed me if I'd come back without it. I'll have to say thanks to Ellen, Theo too.
So should you, Honza. You and your friends don't have to steal anymore. If anyone threatens you again, you know who to turn to.
We do. And we already have. Miss Earl's given us a job shifting the chocobo shit out the stables. It's hard work, and the pay isn't half what we got from the stones. But if we stick at it, we'll keep ourselves fit.
You stick at it, then.
And Goots, I'm sorry for stealing your pass.
That's all right. I've got it back now. And all's well that ends well, eh?
You said you're trained to be a blacksmith, right? Well, I'm going to be your first customer. I'm going to save up all my gear and get you to make me a massive sword.
I'll do me best.
Till then, eh?
All right. We have a place on the wagon. Remember, Goots. We're mercenaries. You hired us to protect you.
Mercenaries.
And you remember the plan? You're to ride all the way to Twinside. Jill and I will go with you as far as the outskirts, then find our own way in.
I'll buy that stuff I need.
Right. And we'll scout out the Imperial's defences.
There's a square with a big bell tower right in the middle of town. If you get lost, or out goes wrong, we can meet up there.
All right. Let's go.
I see. And you're quite certain your father has no knowledge of Ultima?
I am. I have no difficulty believing a sinister force has come to exert an influence on Sanbrek. But be that as it may, it is yet to claim my father. For better or worse, his radiance speaks his own mind.
Then the fiend works from the shadows.
I confess, when first you told me of this fiend, I had my doubts, and more than a few at that. beast that labors to plunge Valisthea into turmoil, all in pursuit of your brother. But that wound is proof enough that evil is afoot.
Then I have your answer, Your Highness. You will join me in my fight.
I cannot. Not yet.
Your Highness, please.
As you are aware, the Dalmechian army is at our gates. They have lost their mother crystal, and with it all hope of a negotiated withdrawal. It is but a matter of time before they invade. If Bahamut is not here to meet them, my people will be slaughtered.
Though not by Hugo Kupka, thanks to Ultima's machinations. I know the fate of your people weighs heavy on your conscience, but if we do not put an end to Ultima's plans, they shall face a far darker fate. The chaos he would wreak would sweep all of Valisthea into the abyss. The lives of every man, woman, and child in the Twins are at stake.
I believe what you say, Phoenix. But I have duties of my own, and I must discharge them. Come what may. What do you know of my blood?
I know that it is wholly unworthy of the highest offices of state, which rightly belong to those of purer breeding. Alas. Your bloodline runs through the Oriflamme gutter, from a whore who weighed her child's worth in gil.
Have you threatened my father?
Of course not. I merely whispered in his ear that his mongrel son is plotting a rebellion.
What?
Sylvester listens to the words of his astrologers. And they have ears too.
You have been feeding them your lies!
Should you remain loyal to Emperor Olivier, his radiance may yet crown your head with laurel, and not with tar.
Fork-tongued witch!
In consideration of your long years of service to the Empire, I shall forgive this uncharacteristic rudeness. Now hurry and make ready, Your Imperial Highness. Emperor Olivier expects much of you, Dion. Or should I say, of Bahamut. May your fire reduce his enemies to ash. Till all of Valisthea bows to its rightful ruler.
There is another darkness that has taken hold of Sanbrek. And until its grip is released, the flames of war shall spread ever wider, just as Ultima wishes.
Forgive me. My family has caused you much grief.
You are not her keeper, Phoenix. This is a matter for the Imperial household now, and as a member of that household, it falls to me to resolve it. At such time as that is done, what strength I have shall be yours.
Thank you, Your Highness.
Let us take to the skies together and bring a new dawn to Valisthea.
I should like nothing more.
Terence.
My prince.
Tell me true. Do you believe what I'm about to do is wrong?
We Dragoons have but one leader, Your Highness. And we shall follow him unto the very end.
Thank you. This is my decree. For their crimes against the crown, the traitorous Annabella and her usurping son shall be put to death, and the Empire restored.
One would never guess that these people stood on the brink of war.
And they're afraid. They turn to drink to forget their fears.
Anything you want to forget?
The harbor is empty, and half the market stalls too. The city may seem peaceful on the surface, but it's balanced on a knife edge. Were we to give it a nudge, it might be just the distraction we need to reach the Mother Crystal.
I thought you might say that. We should send for Gav. We'll need someone to keep the fires we start from going out.
And we can busy ourselves scheming until he gets here.
I'll send a Stolas then.
What is it, boy?
What's happening?
I don't know.
Torgal!
This way.
City's on fire.
I'm sure Gooch is fine. He'll be making for the square.
The one with the bell tower. In the middle of town, right?
Thank you.
Those were Imperial Dragoons.
Going on.
Let's go and see.
Right. But first we find Goots.
I just hope he's all right.
Do we have to? Glad to fall into a sewer.
Evacuation is complete, Captain.
Good. And all that remains is thrown the protector.
There it is. The bell tower.
Right. Let's go. Goods lift.
Guards, we're coming.
Can you see him anywhere?
Now, Torgo!
Over here, Clive! Are you all right?
Goats, there you are.
I didn't know there'd be a dragon.
All right, let's get out of here.
Oh!
What now?
Is that Mother Crystal's heart?
What the hell is it doing up there? The helmet.
Thank you. this.
We must leave. Now, Your Grace, I beg of you.
This is not what he wanted. Something's happened. Forgive me, Yod, but I must put a stop to this.
Your Grace!
So, what do we do now, then?
We destroy the heart.
But he might come back!
As soon as the flames die down, the Imperials and the Dalmechs will move in. This may be our only chance.
And Bahamut has gone for now. You should get as far away as you can, Goots.
What? And leave you slot in the ledge? I can't do that. If you're staying, then so am I. I packed everything up before I made a run for it, so if there's out you need, just ask. But I won't be giving it away for free. Nana'd never forgive us if I did.
Thank you, Goot.
What can I do for yous? I've got some good stuff for yous.
Righto, here you go. Thank you. Else you need? All done then. That's 10 times better than it was before. I hope you like it. Did it? I hope you like it. I did it. That's 10 times better than it was before.
Anything else I can make for you? Is there anything else you need? Thank you. You've got everything you need, then.
You be brave now, boy.
Drake's tail is right there, Clive. It's time to free Storm from the Crystal's curse.
I might need a moment to prepare.
Of course. Drake's tail is right there, Clive. It's time to free Storm from the Crystal's curse.
Oh, it's past time. But remember, Bahamut is still out there.
And I dare say we'll be seeing him again before the night is done. More roads.
We'll have to find our own path.
Do you feel that, Clive?
Ether. Just what we need. Another flood.
It's already turned for me.
And there's no reason to hold back.
It's too dangerous.
Fuck. Hold on, Joshua. I'm coming! We have to save him.
And we will. We just need to keep moving.
Come again. Not now.
Thank you.
Are those the council chambers? How are they still standing?
I don't know.
He'll be all right, Clive. He's a survivor.
We're getting close. Somebody doesn't want us getting any closer.
I don't care what it wants.
Neither do I.
Thank you. These beasts. They're getting stronger.
We can think about them later. Right now, there's only one thing we need to focus on.
The heart.